Welcome to Brihan Mumbai Municipal Corporation's Virtual Training Center. And I am Mrs. Nehal Kodambe, your English teacher from VTC. Let's begin with today's session.
I welcome you all, my Standard 7 children, in our English class. In today's session, we are going to learn a very nice poem which is related to you from our English course book. The name of the poem is Children Are Going to School, which is related to you. Children Are Going to School is written by a very well-known poet. His name is Maqtida Hasan Nida Fazli. He was also known as Nida Fazli. He was a prominent Indian Hindi and Urdu poet, lyricist and dialogue writer. He was awarded the Padma Shri in 2013 by the Government of India for his contribution to the literature. So he is very well known poet, Nida Fazli. So this poem is written by him to you or for you. Let's begin with the reading of this poem. You all will read this poem along with me from your book or from the screen. Morning light spreads over the earth. Once again the sky bows his head in respect, for children are going to school. We will read those lines again. Morning light spreads over the earth. Once again the sky bows his head in respect, for children are going to school. First of all, we will read all the stanzas and then we will see the meaning of those lines. Okay? सुरुवातीला आपण एकदा पूर्ण कविता वाचून घेऊया आणि त्याच्यानंतर त्याचा अर्थ आपण जाणून घेऊया. Actually, this poem is very easy and simple to understand. The next stanza. The sun, after his morning dip in the river, dressed up in his golden muslin turban, waits and smiles on one side of the road, for children are going to school. Third stanza. Through the green top branches, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. Through the green top branches, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. Next stanza. At the corner of the lane, the people in his lush deep foliage waves his hands, for children are going to school. At the corner of the lane, the people in his lush deep foliage waves his hands, for children are going to school. Angels of light have set out. Every road is a gleam. At these hour, every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Angels of light have set out. Every road is a gleam. At these hour, every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Time sitting on an old roof, flies pigeons in the sky, for children are going to school. So the poet has come with these lines, this poem. Time sitting on an old roof, flies pigeons in the sky, for children are going to school. So just now we have read the poem. Now we will see the meaning stanza wise. आता आपली कविता एकदा वाचून झालेली आहे. आता त्याचा अर्थ आपण जाणून घेऊया. सो दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टॅन्झा. वी विल बिगिन विथ द फर्स्ट स्टॅन्झा. मॉर्निंग लाईट स्प्रेड्स over the earth. Morning light spreads over the earth. Once again, the sky bows his head in respect, for children are going to school. Morning light spreads over the earth. Once again, the sky bows his head in respect, for children are going to school. See the meaning of these lines. Morning light spread. As you know, the sun rises in the morning. Okay. And when the sun rises, its light, its beams of light spread over the earth. And poet feels that once again the sky bows his head in respect for children are going to school. बघा कवीने आपली जी कल्पना आहे ती किती सुंदररित्या मांडलेली आहे की रोज सकाळी सूर्य उगवतो, आकाशातले रंग बदलतात, आपण रोज सकाळी उठून शाळेत येतो. हे इतकं सरळ आहे रोजचं जीवन, परंतु जेव्हा कवी त्याच्या नजरेतून बघतो तेव्हा बाळांना तो कसा सांगतो बघा. किती सुंदर त्याने आपल्या शब्दात मांडलेला आहे. मॉर्निंग लाईट स्प्रेड्स ओव्हर द अर्थ. सकाळ झालेली आहे, सूर्याची किरण पृथ्वीवर पडलेली आहेत आणि पुन्हा एकदा जणू शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांच्या आदराने किंवा त्यांचा आदर वाटून आकाशाने आपली मान त्यांच्या समोर झुकवलेली आहे. म्हणजे सकाळचे जे आभाळातले रंग बदलतात त्या रंगांची तुलना किंवा त्या रंगाची उपमा कवीने कशी केलेली आहे की सकाळी उठून जी मुलं शाळेत जातात त्यांना त्यांचा आदर वाटून जणू काही आभाळाने आपली मान झुकवलेली आहे त्यांच्या समोर. मॉर्निंग लाईट स्प्रेड्स ओव्हर द अर्थ. वन्स अगेन द स्काय बोज हिज हेड इन रिस्पेक्ट, फॉर चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टू स्कूल. द नेक्स्ट स्टांझा वी विल रीड द लाइन्स. द सन आफ्टर हिज मॉर्निंग डीप इन द रिवर. बघा किती सुंदर कल्पना आहे. द सन आफ्टर हिज मॉर्निंग डीप इन द रिवर ड्रेस्ड अप इन हिज गोल्डन मसलिंग टर्बन. द सन आफ्टर हिज मॉर्निंग डीप इन द रिवर ड्रेस्ड अप इन हिज गोल्डन मसलिंग टर्बन. जणू काही कवीला असं म्हणायचंय की सूर्याने सकाळी उठून नदीमध्ये एक डुबकी मारून आलाय आणि छानपैकी त्याने आता फेटा घातलाय. कसला घातलाय? गोल्डन मसलिन, मलमल कलर, मलमलीचा असा सोनेरी रंगाचा फेटा जणू काही त्याने परिधान केलेला आहे. वेट्स अँड स्माइल्स ऑन वन साइड ऑफ द रोड. आणि एवढा सगळा तयार होऊन तो रस्त्याच्या एका कडेला उभा राहिलाय किंवा थांबलाय. कोणासाठी? फॉर चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टू स्कूल. शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांसाठी जणू काही तो थांबलेला आहे. तुमच्या आधी उठून नदीत त्याने डुबकी मारून छान तयार झालेला आहे गोल्डन रंगाचा फेटा बांधून आणि शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांसाठी हसत त्यांची वाट पाहत तो रस्त्याच्या एका कोपऱ्यात उभा आहे. द सन आफ्टर हिज मॉर्निंग डीप इन द रिवर ड्रेस्ड अप इन हिज गोल्डन मसलिन टर्बन वेट्स अँड स्माइल्स ऑन वन साइड ऑफ द रोड फॉर चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टू स्कूल. द पोएट फील्स दॅट The sun, before the children gets up early in the morning, he gets before them. Then he takes deep in the river. Then he dresses himself in his golden muslin turban and waits and smiles on one side of the road for the children who are going to school. आता इथे आपण बघा त्याने माणसाची उपमा दिलेली आहे सूर्याला. जसं आपण सकाळी उठून आंघोळ करून तयार होतो फ्रेश एकदम शाळेत जाण्यासाठी, तसं सूर्याने सणुकाई सकाळी उठून नदीत डुबकी मारून छानसा गोल्डन फेटा परिधान करून तो जणू काही मुलांची वाट पाहत उभा आहे. सो दिस इज लाईक पर्सॉनिफिकेशन इन इंग्लिश. हा एक फिगर ऑफ स्पीच आहे आपण शिकणार आहोत पुढे जाऊन. पण इथे त्याने सूर्याला माणसाची उपमा दिली आहे किंवा मानवी रूप दिलेला आहे. The sun after his morning deep in the river, dressed up in his golden muslin turban, waits and smiles on one side of the road for children are going to school. You can see here the beaming lights of the sun. Through the green topped branches, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. You can see here through the green top branches, through the green top branches of the trees, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Breezes, wind, as if wind are singing for the children who are going to school. Which song are they singing? They are singing the songs of blessings. And fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. They are all ready to welcome the children who are going to school. इथेच कवी आपल्याला असं जणूक सांगतायत की सकाळ झाल्यानंतर हिरव्यागार झाडाच्या फांद्यांच्या मधून वारा गाणं गात वाहतोय आणि फुलांचा सुगंधाने जे झोपलेले होते रस्ते रात्रभर ते आता जणू काही सुगंधित झालेले आहेत आणि शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांच्या स्वागतासाठी सज्ज झालेले आहेत. थ्रू द ग्रीन Top branches, breezes sing their songs of blessings. Fragrant flowers awaken the sleepy roads with their melodies. Next lines from next stanza. At the corner of the lane, the people in his lush deep foliage waves his hands for children are going to school. At the corner of the lane, the people in his lush deep foliage waves his hands for children are going to school. Now see, the sky is ready, the sun is ready, the trees are ready, roads are ready, everyone is ready in the nature for welcoming the children who are going to school. At the same time, at the corner of that lane, from where the children will pass, there is a one big peepal tree, and with his lush deep foliage, with its greenery, with lots of leaves, it is waving his hands for children who are going to school. रस्त्याच्या कोपऱ्यावर उभा असलेलं पिंपळाचं झाड जे सतत सळसळत असतं ते पाहून कवीला असं वाटतंय की जणू काही शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांना टाटा बाय बाय करायला ते झाड तयार झालेलं आहे, सज्ज आहे. ऍट द कॉर्नर ऑफ द लेन द पीपल इन हिज लश डीप फॉलिएज वेव्स हिज हँड्स फॉर चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टू स्कूल. बघा, निसर्गातला प्रत्येक जण जणू काही शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांसाठी, त्यांच्या स्वागतासाठी सज्ज झालेला आहे असं कवीला या कवितेतून सुचवायचं आहे. Next stanza. Angels of light have set out, every road is gleam. At this hour, every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Angels of lights have set out. Angels of light means beams of sunlight. Angels of light have set out. Every road is gleam. Gleam shined, brightened. At this hour, every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. Angels of light have set out. Sun has come up with his angels, with its beams, and they have set out now on the earth. And because of them, every road on the earth is gleamed. It has been brightened. And at this time, at this hour, every particle of the earth, every small particle of the earth, it throbs like a mother's heart. It throbs like a mother's heart. I'll explain you this. Angels of lights have set out, every road is gleam. At this hour, every particle of the earth throbs like a mother's heart. कवीला इथे म्हणायचंय की सूर्य उगवलेला आहे, त्याची किरण एंजल्स, त्याचे दूत पृथ्वीवर आलेले आहेत आणि त्यांनी सगळे पृथ्वीचे रस्ते प्रकाशून टाकलेले आहेत. आणि अशा वेळेला पृथ्वीवरचा प्रत्येक कण आणि कण, जसं आईचं हृदय धडधडतं तसं धडधडतंय. का धडधडतंय? बघा, जेव्हा आई तुम्ही लहान असताना तुम्हाला शाळेत सोडायला येते आणि तुम्ही तिचा हात सोडून जेव्हा शाळेत प्रवेश करता तेव्हा आईचं हृदय तुमच्या प्रेमाने धडधडत राहतं. माझं बाळ शाळेत चाललंय, एवढा वेळ मी त्याला आता सोडून राहणार आहे. तर जसं तुम्हाला शाळेत सोडताना, शाळेत पाठवताना तिचं हृदय धडधडत असतं, तसंच आता पृथ्वीवरचा प्रत्येक कण आणि कण त्या मायेने, त्या प्रेमाने धडधडतोय असं कवीला वाटतंय. ऍट दिस आर एव्हरी पार्टिकल ऑफ द अर्थ थ्रोब्स लाईक अ मदर्स हार्ट. And the poet sums up this poem with these lines. Time sitting on the old roof, flies pigeons in the sky, for the children are going to school. Time sitting on an old roof, flies pigeons in the sky, for children are going to school. Even time sitting on an old roof means someone is waiting to come, or someone is waiting for that moment. Time sitting on an old roof means something is going to be happen and someone is waiting for those moments. And flies pigeons in the sky. For whom are they flying? For children are going to school. Even time is also waiting. The moments are also waiting for children to pass by that lane or pass by that moment. And the pigeons are flying to say bye-bye to the children who are going to school. Time sitting on an old roof म्हणजे कुठल्या तरी क्षणाची वाट बघणे. Time sitting on an old roof, flies pigeon in the sky, for children are going to school. Even birds are flying in the sky for the children to wave at them. And everyone in the nature, right from the sky, the sun, the trees, the roads, the flowers, the wind, every particle of the earth and birds, even with the time, all are waiting, all are saying bye-bye, all are waving at the children who are going to school. So going to school, this moment has been made very special by the poet in his poem, The Children Are Going to School. निसर्गातला प्रत्येक घटक शाळेत जाणाऱ्या मुलांची वाट बघतोय, त्यांना बाय बाय करतोय. तो शाळेत जाण्याचा क्षण एन्जॉय करायला सगळे आतुर झालेले आहेत. आणि म्हणून कवी असे म्हणतात की तुमचं किती लाड करतोय बघा निसर्गामधला सूर्य, तुम आभाळ किंवा झाड, नदी, पक्षी, रस्ते, पानं, फुलं, वारा, सगळे तुमची वाट बघतायत. कोणाची वाट बघतायत? जी मुलं शाळेत जात आहेत. आणि त्यांची वाट बघून त्यांना बाय बाय करायचंय. सो दीज मुमेंट ऑफ गोइंग टू स्कूल हॅज बीन मेड व्हेरी स्पेशल बाय द पोएट इन दिस पोएम, चिल्ड्रन आर गोइंग टू स्कूल. सो दॅट वॉज द पोएम. नाऊ वी विल सी सम न्यू वर्ड्स फ्रॉम दिस पोएम. सो ग्लॉसरी मीन्स न्यू वर्ड्स अँड देअर मीनिंग. Breeze, a gentle wind, haluvar vahanara vara. Lush green foliage, we have read those words. Abundant, pushkar, lot of foliage, leaves or greenery of that tree, peepal tree. Some more words, we will read them with their meanings. Gleam, shine or glimmer. Particle, a minute portion of matter. In science, you must have read about it. Anu we call atom, very small portion of a matter. Throbs means beat or pulse. A mother's heart throbs, mother heart beats. So in this way, in today's session, we have learned a very nice poem which is related to all of you. Children are going to school, written by Nida Fazli. And this poem is basically in Urdu language. So you please read or listen that poem. And then you listen this poem's video also. And then find out some more new words and write down the meanings of these new words. So that's all for today. See you in next session with new topic. Till then, bye bye.
That's all for today. So you will revise whatever we have learned in today's session. Please subscribe the channel and press the notification button to get the link of next video. Bye bye.